Shubhakant, do you have a question here for the secretaries before I get to GST and other issues? Ashmit, the microphone, please.
First, let me take a minute to congratulate you and through you, the Honorable Finance Minister, on a budget which I think is growth-oriented. It has a strong element of continuity, inclusivity, and I think the focus on the fiscal glide path gives it a lot of credibility. So all of this coming together, I think, is a great thing. Being from the manufacturing sector myself, I'm particularly happy to see the focus over the last several years and a reiteration of that in this budget about promoting domestic manufacturing and export competitiveness. And speaking on behalf of FICCI, again, thank you for including many of the suggestions that we have made. I think they found their place in this budget. One of the points we have talked about consistently at FICCI is about green taxonomy. And there was a reference to that in the Honorable Finance Minister's speech. So I just wanted to ask if you could, if it's possible to elaborate on that a little bit more as to what is the thinking and more importantly the timeline, because this is something, you know, given the importance attached to energy transition and how well we have done as a country in that regard, you know, I think putting this together in place sooner rather than later is important. So just a thought process on what the thought process is like and sort of a hint about the timeline. Thank you.
You're catching me in a zone of ignorance in terms of this. I'm not very well informed on the proposed green taxonomy. I know that the intention is that we need a taxonomy so that financing can be directed towards those parts of our economy, those parts of our activities that are green. So what is green, what is not green? What qualifies for green financing, what doesn't? What qualifies for certain benefits and doesn't? So we need some consistency, because what is green to you may be black to me, and so on. So the aim is to provide a consistent taxonomy and not necessarily rely on international models. Look at what is relevant to India, because India has a lot of knowledge and a lot of experience, and we, even as our Prime Minister keeps saying, Indian lifestyles are often greener than international lifestyles per se, for various cultural, historical and other reasons. So we need our own taxonomy, but beyond that, how long will it take to evolve it? What parameters would it have? I confess that the person who could give you a better answer is not in this session, which is my colleague, Mr. Ajay Seth. And I've told you what I know about it.
You know, and we did ask Mr. Seth exactly that question yesterday. But Mr. Somnathan, you know, things like green taxonomy, as you pointed out, are work in progress. But many other thrust areas pointed out by the finance minister, including the financial sector overhaul reform roadmap that she also spoke of. Could you give us some indication of what that entails? What are we talking about? What kind of timelines are we looking at? Because many of those thrust areas, you know, still require the nuts and bolts and the sketch, the
so,
fleshing out.
The timeline is not something that we are specifying now, and it's not necessarily something that will come before February the 1st. I mean, I would say that for the financial sector vision, the target date is not February 1, 2025.
So we shouldn't be ready for it.
It's a big exercise in terms of what should India's financial sector look like for a developed India by 2047. And what changes would you want in which sectors? Banking, financial markets, insurance, pensions. So the whole range of financial services. And what would you envisage in each of them? What regulatory changes might be required? It's a vision document that is being thought about. And so what would that vision be? And how do you get to that vision? What would it require from the government? What would it require from regulators? So these are the kinds of things that will find a place in that vision document.
Okay.
But it will take some time, because it will need consultation, not just within the government, not just with regulators, but obviously with the financial sector participants, market participants. So it will be an elaborate exercise. It will take some time. And it's something that we're using to prepare for the next quarter century, not for the next year.
Okay, so don't expect anything over the next 6-8, perhaps even longer than that. That's the indication coming in from you. Since we are talking about the financial sector, Mr. Somnathan, and we have more questions here, but let me also throw in a question as far as what we are currently seeing. And you talked about the distortion with respect to savings, and some of the measures that were announced were on account of being able to correct that or avert any possible accidents as well. You know, if you could broadly explain to us, what is the concern at this point in time, if any, that North Block has with the distortions that you spoke of, especially as far as the savings side is concerned on the deposit mobilization by banks? Is there a concern considering that they are facing a challenge there? And how do you believe that that should be addressed at this point in time? Is there a role for the regulator and for the government?
That's a very comprehensive question to which I will give you a less comprehensive answer. I mean, what I will say is that, so are there concerns? Well, you saw some points of view expressed in the economic survey about, you know, particularly on the issue of speculation and so on. So, yes, but are they to be addressed through taxation measures or taxation measures alone? No. So is there a role for regulators there? Of course, yes. When it comes to speculation, what's the – you every market – I mean, markets need speculators. A liquid market, whether it's in shares, commodities, derivatives, needs speculation. Speculation is the lubricating oil that keeps the market, you know, running smoothly. But where does it go too far in terms of being, you know, the tail beginning to wag the dog and so on?
Are we there?
That's not something that let me put it this way. In regard to the stock market, the ratio of futures and options trading to the volumes on the cash market in India is unprecedented globally and historically. It's unprecedented historically in India and unprecedented globally in terms of all other well-developed financial markets.
So if that is
the case, I would say prima facie there is some room for concern. What the government would obviously want to encourage is investment. Now, investment in the stock market is investment, but speculation in the stock market, not necessarily bad, but is not investment. So some of the changes that were made or proposed yesterday on taxation, such as a higher rate on short-term capital gains, such as a higher transaction tax on futures and options, are sort of mild steps to nudge people in the right direction, but will they suffice? I don't think so. Ultimately, these things will respond more to regulatory action than to tax changes. But if something is happening which I don't think is a very good thing, then surely I should at least collect taxes from it, like we collect it from tobacco and horse racing and gambling or whatever. We shouldn't let it go untaxed at the very least. So that's what we have done. Now, coming to things like fixed deposits, again, we are trying to eliminate tax-based distortions between asset classes. So, again, even if you look at the issue of indexation, shouldn't there be indexation of fixed deposits if there's indexation of property? So the point is we cannot look at asset classes in isolation. There is a historic background. Some things have got indexation, some things have not. But that's not necessarily meaning that the existing structure is the perfect one. And if there is a tax-induced move away from fixed deposits, then we don't want that to happen. We are not saying invest in fixed deposits, but we're saying don't discourage people from fixed deposits just because it's adversely treated by taxes. So that is part of the philosophy in which some of these changes have been done.
Mr. Somanathan and Mr. Malhotra, always a pleasure. Appreciate you joining us here on the CNBC TV 18 Budget Verdict to field all the questions that have come in from us, our viewers, and of course, industry that is here with us in the Capitol, talking to both secretaries. Appreciate you joining us here on the Budget Verdict. Thank you very much for your time. We are going to take a break here on the CNBC TV 18 Budget Verdict, but don't go anywhere. We're going to be back with the chairmen of the CBIC and the CBDT. They join us here on the Budget Verdict right after this. Stay with us. We're back in a moment.